Everybody, my topic is congenital heart diseases. Classification is done into right to left shunts and left to right shunts along with obstructive lesions. So the right to left shunts consist of early cyanosis, hence these babies are called blue babies. The diagnosis is done prenatally or immediately after birth and it requires urgent surgical treatment. You can remember this with the mnemonic 5 T's E squared VP. So the first T is one vessel, which is persistent, which is the truncus arteriosus, two switched vessels, transposition of great vessels, tricuspid atresia, tetralogy of Fallot, and five letters as in TAPVR, or total anomalous pulmonary venous return. We also have Epstein anomaly, Eisenmenger syndrome, VSD with pulmonic stenosis, and pulmonary arteriovenous malformation. The left to right shunts are acyanotic at presentation, but cyanosis can occur later years. It includes ventricular septal defect and atrial septal defect, and VSD is the most frequent congenital heart disease. Obstructive lesions include patent ductus arteriosus, coarctation of aorta, infundibular stenosis, pulmonary valve stenosis, and congenital mitral or tricuspid regurgitation. So the first lesion we're going to discuss is transposition of great vessels. So the aorta leaves the right ventricle and the pulmonary trunk leaves the left ventricle. There's separation of the systemic and pulmonary circulations, but it is not compatible with life unless there is a shunt, which allows the mixing of blood. Due to failure of the aortico-pulmonary septum to spiral, this transposition occurs. There's an egg of string appearance on chest X-ray. Without surgical intervention, most infants die within the first few months of life. Next is tetralogy of Fallot, which is caused by the anterosuperior displacement of the infundibular septum. Most common cause of early childhood cyanosis. You can remember the features with a mnemonic proof. P is for pulmonary infundibular stenosis, R is for right ventricular hypertrophy, O is for overriding aorta, V is for VSD. Pulmonary stenosis forces right to left flow across the VSD, leading to RVH. There are TET spells, which are often caused by crying, fever, and exercise due to exacerbation of right ventricular outflow obstruction. Squatting increases the SVR, decreases right to left shunt, and improves cyanosis. It is associated with 20q11 syndromes. Next is Epstein anomaly. In which there is displacement of the tricuspid valve leaflets downwards into the right ventricle, artificially atrializing the ventricle. It is associated with tricuspid regurgitation, accessory conduction pathways, and right-sided heart failure. It can be also caused by lithium exposure in utero, and the common anomaly is box-shaped heart on chest X-ray. There are other right-to-left shunts such as persistent truncus arteriosus, in which the truncus arteriosus fails to divide into the pulmonary trunk and aorta due to failure of the aortico-pulmonary septum formation, and most patients have accompanying VSD. In tricuspid atresia, there's absence of tricuspid valve and hypoplastic RV. It requires both ASD and VSD for viability. There's also total anomalous pulmonary venous return, in which the pulmonary vein drains into the right heart circulation. It is associated with ASD and sometimes PDA to allow for right to left shunting to maintain cardiac output. You can see the snowman's heart appearance on chest X-ray. Next are the left to right shunts. The ventricular septal defect is asymptomatic at birth and may manifest weeks later or may remain asymptomatic throughout life. Most self-resolve, but the larger lesions may lead to left ventricular overflow and heart failure. Oxygen saturation in the right ventricle and pulmonary artery are increased. Atrial septal defect. There's defect in the interatrial septum. There's wide fixed split S2 sound. Ostium second defects are the most common and usually an isolated finding. Ostium primum defects are rarer and usually occur with other cardiac anomalies. Symptoms range from none to heart failure. There's distinct from patent foramen ovale in that septa are missing tissue rather than unfused. O2 saturation increases in right atrium, right ventricle, and pulmonary artery. It may lead to paradoxical emboli and it's associated with Down syndrome. Obstructive lesions include coarctation of the aorta, in which there's aortic narrowing near the insertion of the ductus arteriosus, so it's also known as juxtaductal. Associated with bicuspid aortic valve, other heart defects, as well as Turner syndrome. There's hypertension in upper extremities and weak delayed pulse in lower extremities. With age, the intercostal arteries enlarge due to collateral circulation and the arteries erode the ribs, giving a figure of three appearance on chest X-ray. Complications include heart failure, increased risk of cerebral hemorrhage, aortic rupture, and possible endocarditis. The last obstructive lesion is patent ductus arteriosus. In the fetal period, the shunt is from right to left normally. In the neonatal period, pulmonary vascular resistance decreases and the shunt becomes left to right. Progressive RVH and or LVH and heart failure are also seen. It is associated with a continuous machine-like murmur. Patency is maintained by prostaglandin E synthesis and low oxygen tension. Uncorrected PDA can eventually result in late cyanosis in the lower extremity, so it's differential cyanosis. Thank you, this is a quick recap.